The gentleman, Madam Speaker, I rise in support of my two amendments that were made part of the en banc that we're debating. My First Amendment reflects congressional intent for the Army to prioritize necessary funding for its combat development centers. These centers throughout the United States play a critical role in ensuring a capable and ready ground force. Take, for example, Fort Polk, which is home to the Joint Readiness Training Center, the JRTC. It's located in Louisiana's 4th Congressional District near my home. Fort Polk, JRTC, provides invaluable training to prepare for the unique situations and challenges the unit may face while being deployed. As we continue to grow our ground forces, investing in the necessary infrastructure to replace the existing facilities at Fort Polk, such as the Joint Operations Center, we remember that that's paramount. This much-needed upgrade would allow our troops better training to ensure full readiness for when our men and women in uniform are called upon to defend freedom around the world. My Second Amendment ensures congressional intent that the Air Force continues to maintain its revised plan for construction and upgrades to the Weapons Generation Facility Enterprise. Ensuring these critical upgrades to those facilities is critical to the national security interest of the U.S., especially given the recent aggressive actions from our adversaries. Deterrence is a requisite to maintaining peace, and if Congress is going to be serious about preserving our nuclear infrastructure, these upgrades must be prioritized. My home state of Louisiana has invested millions of dollars to pave the way for the Weapons Generation Facility at Barksdale Air Force Base, home to Global Strike Command. I urge the Air Force to continue to work with Congress and the Louisiana delegation to support the wide array of strategic deterrents that we do there at Global Strike. In closing, I'm proud to represent both these vital military installations here in Congress. Both are critical to our national security interest in the United States, and I appreciate the Appropriations Committee for giving it due attention. I urge support of both amendments. I yield back.